Hey everyone, today we will carve a maxillary right canine incisor. We cut the label of the soap. And now we will draw canine's labial face. I didn't use measurements this time, but you can use if you want. I will use all the thickness of the soap. I will tell the ratio now. Crown length is 10 units, mesial distal is 7, and buccolingual is 8 units. In canine, mesial inclination is shorter than distal. Also, distal outline is more convex compared to mesial. As you can see here, mesial is shorter than distal. Then we cut from lines. And we will get this view. As you can see, mesial is shorter than distal. And now from mesial, we draw it again. Again, we will draw from 1/3 cervical to the tubercule. And we cut. And from incisal aspect, as you can see, teeth gets narrow to the cingulum, so we will cut these lines. Also, you can round if you want. We cut from all corners. And now, all we have to do is round the corners. From labial view, mesial and distal outline are more concave through the cervical. There is a significant convexity on the labial surface, closer to the cervical of the tooth. Apex of the tubercule is located mesially according to the highest point of the cervical line. Keep in your mind these notes while carving. From mesial view, maxillary canine is bigger than all the other anterior teeth. cervical 1/3 is the widest part labiolingually. Labial outline is more convex compared to all other teeth. Lingual outline is convex at the cingulum, straight at middle 1/3, and convex at the incisal 1/3. The line that divides the crown of the tooth into two pieces is located labial of the line, dividing the root into two pieces. It also means that tubercle is little bit located to the labial. From distal view, distal surface is smaller than the mesial surface. Thus, when we look from this aspect, we can see labial and lingual surface formations. So you have to curve this side more. Tubercle apex and center of the root are on the same axis line. Since the tooth consists of three lobes, mesial, middle and distal lobes are separated from each other by the shallow grooves, and you can use the other side of the wax knife while creating these grooves. In lingual view, crown gets narrower towards the lingual. Cingulum is the most significant formation on lingual surface. Cervical line curvature is significant. As you remember, we always draw an M ladder. M ladder little bit shifted to mesial. There are thick mesial and distal ridge, center of the crown appears as a ridge. There are lingual grooves on both sides of the lingual ridge, they are called mesial or distal lingual fossa. From incisal view, incisal edge is inclined 45 degrees labiolingually. You can clearly see the width of the labiolingual edge. Usually, labiolingual size is wider than mesiodistal size. According to center of the tooth, tubercle apex is located labially on the labiolingual direction and mesially on the mesiodistal direction. We check our carvings according to the model. Also, you can check according to these pictures I share. We are doing small adjustments before the polishing. And first we use sponge to eliminate knife marks. Then socks. And finally, seitan. Let's take a look to our carving from each side. Hope you enjoy. See you in the next video.